So last year we did a video about electric bike trends for 2020, and I figured since it's 2021, it's only right to do another. And this year, a lot has changed. The global pandemic has changed quite a bit. One of the big things is just that more people are home, less people are working, but overall, electric bike popularity is up quite a bit. Now, I'm sure there's a variety of different reasons why that's the case, but some of the more notable ones seem to be that more people are living locally, they're, you know, getting out, exploring their own neighborhoods and environments, etc. Perhaps less people are commuting to work, or there's less of that need, so they might end up using a bike instead of a car. It also could be more cost effective to use a bike instead of a car, and I think that that's another factor that's impacting a lot of people, so important thing to consider there as well. But with this popularity, it's created a lot of other challenges. Now, availability has been a really big challenge this past year, and it seems to be increasingly a challenge, not necessarily decreasing, as some would suspect. The reality is that the bike industry was not really prepared for this, and you can't really expect that they would be. I mean, you're seeing this dramatic increase in demand, and to have manufacturing scale up so quickly to be able to keep up with that, it's not as easy as just say, like, oh, let's just manufacture more. You actually have to build additional facilities, hire more people, all these sort of things. So this is kind of what we're seeing now, and I think that's probably going to be another year or two before we actually get caught up. In the meanwhile, there's just going to be unique challenges for getting bikes, and I think people have to get kind of comfortable with different types of buying and pre-ordering, reserving, and looking around, etc. I mean, we try to be more aggressive with our purchasing strategies and that sort of thing, and that seems to be working relatively well for us right now. But I do anticipate that it's going to continue to be a challenge for some time to come. With that, we've also seen some increases in pricing, unfortunately, as well. And some would say that, oh yeah, increased demand, yeah, you know, naturally people are going to increase prices, but actually it's not specifically that. It's more so that there's been an increase in demand in some of the dependent products and services. For example, shipping containers, a really big one. The cost for shipping containers has gone up very dramatically, and not to mention there's a much lower supply of them available as well. So that alone has caused a big increase on products, most of which in the US tend to be imported. So that's a big deal. And not to mention raw materials, there's an increase in cost for that and that sort of thing. So there's a lot that goes into that. Hoping that trend doesn't necessarily continue. Maybe we've kind of seen the worst of it, and that's going to fizzle out. Currency fluctuation is another thing, but you know, I'm not an expert on this topic, but these are some of the details which can be a factor in that regard. But also with this increased popularity, we're seeing increased interest on all fronts, you know, whether it's from the media, so I've seen a lot more press coverage on electric bikes and a lot more interest in that regard. But there's also more business interest as well, seeing more brands entering the space, which is definitely interesting and cool, and I could appreciate. I mean, in my shop specifically, we tend to try to primarily work with brands that have been around a long time, so we can know that we can rely on them, that they have a little bit more in that sticking power, because unfortunately, as many new brands enter, there's often many brands exiting at the same time. It's not necessarily the easiest thing. Perhaps these days, maybe it's getting easier in some ways and that the demand is increased, but actually the supply chain problems could make it more challenging. I don't want to get too much into that, but I think, you know, more brands is cool. Overall, the brands that have been in the space, I think that we're seeing a lot more maturity from them, you know, where the brands are getting mature, they're really starting to invest more in their product, they're able to think a bit more long term and think, you know, more 3, 5, 10 years out from now, and I really respect and appreciate that. So another trend we had spoken about last year, and it's really continuing, as I'm sure most people would probably expect, is just more integration of technology. More specifically, one of the big trends these days is the Internet of Things, and really just this connectivity of all of our devices to the internet, to, you know, connecting the bike, etc. Bosch has introduced many smart displays and having the ability to connect maps and connect different health data. That's another big one. I think that we're going to see a lot more of that in the future, especially as we start to see these e-bikes as, you know, really a mechanism to improve health. I think that we might see certain things like actually reducing insurance rates based on the use of the electric bike. So to be able to adequately report that health data will be an interesting thing to follow. And I think we're starting to see a little bit more on that note. We're seeing just overall some of these trends that kind of seem to be like these new niche sort of details like belt drives and electronic shifting becoming a bit more commonplace as many companies start to integrate them into their product offerings. I mean, historically, Risa Mueller was a brand that was one of the few brands that actually offered a belt drive and electronic shifting, and now we're starting to see it from some other brands like Tern, for example. Now they have their GSDs with the belt drive on there, and then they have the R14 with the roll-off electronic shifting, which is quite cool. And then we also see like Gazelle, for example, now they're doing belt drives as well. So that's a big trend and one we're a big fan of. Actually, these days, quite a bit of bikes that we sell are belt driven. I think that just makes a lot of sense for, you know, if you're riding, commuting to work, you just don't want to fuss with the maintenance of a chain and grease and that sort of thing. But I'd be interested to know, what are some of the technology trends that you would like to see, or perhaps that you think that we should see in the future? Maybe you could leave a comment and let us know your thoughts. There's another technological advancement that I didn't speak about before, and it's this new like manufacturing technique of 3D printing e-bike frames, or more specifically bike frames, but this one happens to be an e-bike as well. And they're actually printing the frame specifically to your body proportions, which I think is pretty cool. I actually heard this guy on a podcast and I thought it was pretty interesting, and they're investing a lot in this space. I'm always a little bit questionable about, you know, some of these things, like, are they actually going to last? Are they going to stick around? I mean, you have all these companies that can be like a flash in a pan, but I definitely respect what they're doing and like where they're trying to go with this. I think this is interesting and something maybe we'll see more of this in the future. Another big trend is testing. So we're seeing more testing in the industry. Tern put out a press release not too long ago that they were doing some testing in Germany for this new cargo bike standard, which their bikes pass. And I think a lot of things we see, these standards kind of coming out of Germany, the market's a bit more mature there. They have testing standards for tires, for really the bikes overall. And I think that sort of stuff will probably end up making its way to the US as well. Another big standard for testing, specifically in the US, is UL. Now, this at the moment is not required at all. Bosch is the only company that does it voluntarily. It's part of the reason why we work exclusively with them, because they're the only ones that actually implement this safety standard. But I do think that in the coming years, this will become more of a requirement, because there can be some hazards with electric bike batteries and that sort of thing when they're not tested, because there is no requirement for that, which I'll probably have a video on that topic in the future, but, you know, important thing to consider there. Electric bike share has been another really big trend these days, and we're seeing that implemented in pretty much all major markets throughout the country. New York City has been a really notable one, as it's one of the biggest programs in the world, actually. And so we're seeing more and more e-bikes there, among other places, and I think we'll continue to see that. And I'm really hopeful about this. I feel really good about it. It's like more opportunities for people to test e-bikes in a really simple way. Not to mention, they seem to be a lot more popular. We actually did a video about the electric bike share bike in New York City. You might want to check that out. But outside of electric bike share, another category that we're seeing really grow in popularity is cargo bikes. This past year especially, and I think this will continue to be the case, I'm not sure. I kind of get the sense it's part of this. People living a more local lifestyle, more parents getting into riding bikes with their kids. Electric cargo bikes for that purpose have been super popular. I guess not to mention, you know, many people might be like in this homeschooling situation and just need a way to like get out of the house and take the kids to the park or something like that. It's a great way to go. But also on the commercial side, we're seeing this grow tremendously. So we actually have some pretty large, notable commercial clients we don't talk about right now, but that's a growing thing. It's going to grow a lot more, and we'll probably be talking more about that soon. And we're not just seeing more public support for electric bikes, we're seeing a lot more government support as well. There's been a lot more legislation around electric bikes in a positive form. We're seeing more access, national parks opened up access to electric bikes, and we're seeing many states just improve their laws and just kind of catch up with the times, if you will. That's one of the challenges that can happen with time and new technology. Legislators are not always as quick enough to react through that process, but some other legislation that we're also seeing, which is really interesting and we've been trying to do some coverage on, is related to rebates. This seems to be a very popular trend. There's some smaller programs kind of currently active throughout the states and throughout the world, and for that matter. There's actually legislature currently in New York, California, many other states, as well as the federal level. And I think that is a really big deal, and it could kind of just give you an idea of some of the priorities of these governments to get more people active out on bikes and different forms of transportation and that sort of thing. So I think that we're going to continue to see that trend in the coming years as well. And the last point I want to cover, but is by no means the only other trend, is just more places to ride. You know, as I mentioned, national parks is now open to electric bikes. We're seeing more open spaces locally, more infrastructure, and there seems to be a bigger commitment from the current administration to invest more in bike infrastructure and other green technologies. So I think we'll continue to see that. In New York, we're seeing a dramatic increase in infrastructure in a place where it was already improving pretty well. Now they're talking about shutting down several car lanes in some different bridges to allow more access to bikes and other notable improvements to the infrastructure. And I think some of the new administration coming into New York City will be more positive on bikes as well, which is pretty exciting. And yeah, then we just have like more bike lanes everywhere. And I think we're just moving in the right direction there. And it's going to be interesting to see what comes. I'm really grateful and thankful to be in this position, to be connected to this industry in this way today, and I'm really excited to see what comes. I'm interested to know what other trends you're seeing, what are you excited about, and I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Well, see you soon.